My.
So Unix file permissions and Linux file permissions, there is slight difference between the two. Okay. When you talk about the Unix file permissions, you are talking only about the DAC, that is discretionary access control model. Whereas when you talk about the Linux permissions, you talk about the discretionary access control together with mandatory access control. So what I mean by discretionary, in Unix permissions, we have permissions defined up as our U for the user, user permissions, group level permissions, other level permissions, and on top of them ACL. So Unix file permission model is a four layer model. That is, when you have to apply file permissions, the permissions will be applied at four layers. First layer, the user level. That is, where a specific user is granted or revoked permissions from. Second, permissions at the group, collaborative level permissions. First is the individual permission, that is you. So user permissions are also called up as individual privileges. Privileges given to an individual user. Group level privileges, privileges given to a collective members or collaborative members. So collective permissions are called up as my group permissions. And permissions which do not belong to an individual or to the member of a group are the privileges given to everybody else. Okay. And ACL are my selective permission from to the member who does not have any privilege. So user level permissions, we call it up as individual privilege. Group level permissions, we call up as collective permissions. Others, for everyone except the user and group members. Okay. So these are the permissions for everyone. And ACL, selective privileges. That could be to a user, that could be to a group. Okay. So U is my individual permissions. G is my collective permissions, O is permissions to everyone except the user and group, and ACL is my selective permissions to a specific user. This model in Unix world is called up as my discretionary access control model. This is called up as my DAC permission model. Okay. So in DAC model, we specify the permissions. Here the thing is, it's my discretion. It's my choice. Here the security is my choice. It is me who is going to select what I want to grant to the individual, to the group members, to everybody else, or to a selective member. This is at my sole discretion, at my sole choice. Okay. That is the Unix privilege model. Linux also supports the Unix privileges model. Unix permission model is supported by Linux also. But in Linux, together with this discretionary access control model, there is one more level of privilege. There is one more layer of security. And that layer of security is called up as your MAC, which is a layer overlapping the DAC privileges. That is, DAC privileges are overridden, or you can say are overlapped by MAC. MAC is my mandatory access control. DAC is discretionary, at my choice, whereas MAC is mandatory. Either I want or I don't want, I need to have it. It's something like either I want or I don't want, I need to get a visa stamped on my passport for getting entry to the country. If I don't have a visa stamped on my passport and I am not a resident of the country, I cannot get inside. That is a mandatory thing. And if I am coming up without that process, then in that case I am an illegal immigrant. And all illegal objects have to be thrown out. So if caught, either I would be behind the bars or I would be thrown out of the country. That's what happens. The same thing is here. MAC is a layer of privilege that does what? That prevents any unauthorized access to the resources. That is my choice. This is the choice of immigration officer. He may grant me visa or he may reject my visa. But I need to have a visa. And for visa, I need to have a passport. So that having a passport and having a visa is a mandatory thing. Visa granted or not granted, that has a discretion. That's at the choice. So discretionary access control, before visa to be granted or not to be granted, the first thing is, it is mandatory for me to have a valid passport. So that mandatory layer, that mandatory level of security in my Linux environment is called as SE Linux. We call it up as security enabled Linux or security enhanced Linux. On top of your discretion permissions, there is one more layer of security that is called as your mandatory access control, and this mandatory access control is implemented by the concept of SE Linux. Okay. So in technical terms, the name is SE Linux, and generally we call it up as the mandatory layer of security. This is the mandate. Without having my mandatory security, Linux environments are not by default deployed, especially when you are talking about the Red Hat. So on RHEL server, from RHEL 6 onwards, when you do the installation, it is by default enabled. And the mandatory layer of security is by default there. Okay, so we will talk about both these in one shot. Discretionary access control model followed by the mandatory access control model. Okay, so for the understanding of my discretionary access control model, we have permissions defined as 4 digits. When you check the file permissions, there are 4 digits that control the permissions. Permissions can be set on my files or directories either in symbolic mode or in my absolute mode. Okay, there are total 4 values. First is my special permissions. Special means special. Not everybody will be having them because the name is special permission. So first digit specifies my special privileges. Second digit specifies the permissions of the file owner. The user who owns my file. Okay. Third digit shows me the privileges of the members of group. What this particular group members are going to have permissions. And the last one are the permissions for except this and the group members, everybody else. So anyone whose name is not coming into the owner column, whose name is not coming into the group column, will be a part of my others. Now how I will identify that who is owner and who is group? It's very easy to identify it. When you execute your command ls-l, let's say I executed /home, so here I am getting up some information. Okay, so in this case, let us take up this line only and understand it. Okay, so here, who is the owner of directory Harry? How I will get to know? Remember always, when you check the ls-l is showing me what? ls-l is showing me the permissions or the values coming from inode table. Okay, so here D, the very first value, is my file type. This is my file type specifier. Then there are, if you count, total 9 dashes. Except this, the first dash, there are total 9 dashes, which are grouped into 3 sections here. First section, the first 3 dashes, then 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3. So how many dashes are there? 3, 3, 3, total 9. Okay. These are the permissions of my file owner, or we call them as the user permissions. This set is called up as my permissions for the group members, or we call it up as the group permissions. And these are called up as the permissions of others or everyone else. So we say that these are my user permissions, these are my group permissions, and these are my permissions for others or everyone else. Okay. And this small dot, this is a specification of my ACL. So if in case, in place of this dot, there is a plus, it means the file is having a special or selective permissions configured. Whereas if in case you have a dot, it means there are no selective permissions configured for this file. Okay. Now who is this user? Who will get this set of permissions? Simple, very easy method. How you will identify it? Whatever name appears in this column here, whatever is the name written here, this user will get this set of permissions. Simple. How you will identify that, what are the user permissions? Whatever name appears in your column number 3 of ls minus l, this third column is having the permissions in your first 3 dashes. Okay. Whatever group name comes in here into your column number 4, he will have this set of permissions. And apart from this user and the members of this group, all other users existing on your system, they will have this set of permissions. Simple. Okay. So what are my owner permissions, or what, who is my file owner? Whatever name XYZ, whatever name appears in this column is your file owner. Whatever name appears into this fourth column will have the group level privileges. So this is the name of a group. Members of this group are going to have this set of permissions there. Simple. So leave this username, leave the members of this group, whomsoever else is left on your system except root will have this set of permissions. Simple. Clear? Okay. So here my permissions are specified in two ways. We specify our permissions either in symbolic format or using my absolute or octal format. We call it up as octal format, we call it as absolute format, we call it up as numeric format. Any of the three names, whichever you are comfortable, you can use it. Okay. So read permissions are denoted by the symbol R and a absolute value of 4. Write permissions are denoted by the symbol W and an absolute value of 2. Execute permissions are denoted by the symbol X or absolute value 1. When I want to grant all permissions, then we denote it by using A, all. And in absolute mode, we define it by using 7. No permissions are denoted by dash and here by 0. So when we set the file permissions, when we use our chmod command, so while executing my chmod command, I have to use 3 digits for setting my file permissions, where the value of first digit specifies my owner permissions. Whereas here in symbolic mode, you do it by using the U plus or U minus. If you want to give group some permission, you use G plus or G minus. If you want to grant everyone some permissions, you use O plus or O minus. So in symbolic mode, we actually perform the addition and subtraction of permissions. Whereas In absolute mode, we perform a overwriting of the permissions. When we use the absolute mode of permission management, we do it using the absolute overwriting. We replace the existing permissions with the new one. So first digit here states my user bits, second digit specifies my group bits, and third digit specifies the permissions for everyone. You need to grant a permission plus it in symbolic. In absolute mode, we don't have anything. We just replace it. We don't add or replace, we don't add, we don't subtract. In absolute mode, we simply replace. Whatever the existing permissions were, I don't worry about it. I want this to be the new permissions. Just that. What you have, I don't matter with that. I just want this you should have. So you should have only this much. What you have, it's not my money. It's not worried about me. Okay? So grant and revoke, there is nothing into your absolute mode, but in symbolic mode you use a plus or minus. Okay. Let's take in a quick example of it to understand the things better. So here, let's say we created a directory mkdir minus p say slash common. Okay. Now in this common directory, so what are the permissions of this directory? Can you tell me what are the permissions? What are the permissions for the owner of the file? First question, who is the file owner? Second question, what are the file owner permissions? What is the name of my file owner here? Can you identify? Root. This is my file owner. You don't have to use any logic. Just simply look what value is written into your third column. He is the file owner. Simple. Whatever name appears into third column is the file owner. Okay. And what permissions does he have? Read, write, execute. How we got to know? Because if you check here, leave the first dash, that is my file type. The next three are having a value as read, write, execute. So what is read in my absolute? 4. What is write in my absolute? 2. And what is execute in my absolute? 1. Do a summation of this. This is the first digit in your absolute permissions. So the value is 7. Okay. Now who is, what is the group name here? So group name again is my root. What permissions the group member is having? Write and read and execute, not write and execute. You have only read and execute. There is no write. That dash is left blank. So he is having this set of permissions. So permissions are 4, 0 and 1. Summate it again. What is the value we are having? 5. So my file owner is having a value 7. My group members are having a value 5. That means read and execute. And everybody else is also having a similar value. So these are the permissions for my everyone. Everyone is going to have this set of permissions. So again, if we do the calculation here, so what my value is? 4 plus 0 plus 1 equals to 5. So what is the resultant set of permissions? If I have to write it in my absolute mode, it is 7, 5, 5. Where the first 7 is the permissions of my file owner, second digit 5 is the permission of my group members, and third digit 5 is the permissions of my everybody else. Got it? How we got the absolute permissions? Okay. Now, if in case, in this scenario, I want to take write permission from the user, execute permission from the user, and give write permission to my group member and write permission to my others. How I will do it? First example, using the symbolic method. CHMOD, change mode, is the command for changing your file permissions. Okay. Now what we want to do is, we want to take the write and execute permission from the owner. So u minus wx. Okay, and I want that my group member should have read and write permission and the other should have only write and execute permission. So that is here what we want to do is we want to add w here and take out r from here. And here, so here I want to take out this x and I want to have rw. What we want the resultant set of permissions to be r w. Okay, sorry, my resultant permissions we want to have here, the new permissions is only r for the owner, then dash, then dash, then here I want to have r w, then dash, then I want to have dash w and x. This is the set of permissions we want to have. What is my, see how easy it will be if I am using the absolute mode. What this permission means? 4 plus 0 plus 0. Resultant is 4 only. What this means? 4 and 2 and then 0. So that is simply 6. And here what it is? 0, 2, 1. So that is 3. So if I am doing chmod 463 followed by my file name, my permission will be immediately changed to this, what we designed. But when I am doing it using my symbolic mode, see how lengthy the process is going to be. Because first what I want is, I want to have write and execute. Okay? Because here we wanted to kept only this, read, r. So wx to be removed, comma, what I want to have? I want to grant the read and write permission but want to take the x. So g plus w comma g minus x. Because I have to take the execute and I have to give the write. Then from others I want to take the read permission and give the write permission. So o minus r comma o plus w on my file slash common. Quite lengthy it is, na? And I have to use lot of brains, is it or not? While setting up using this, I have to use a lot of brains here. This to add, this to subtract, this to add, this to subtract, then I am going to get the proper permissions. That's what we wanted. R dash dash RW dash dash WX. This is what we have selected there. See how much brains you have to use here for getting this permission. Let's create another directory, mkdir slash co. Current permissions are this. I want to get the same set of permissions again using my absolute mode. How easy it would be? Chmod, what we wanted? 4. What these permissions are? This is my 4 here, this is my 6 here, and this is my 3 here. So if I simply say chmod 463 followed by slash co, my life will be easy. Done. So tell me where you have to use more brains, in symbols or in numbers? Numbers. Numbers. Really? Think it here. Here you have to just do this. And here you have to do all this maths. Which is easy? It's your choice. You have two methods. Whichever you feel comfortable, you can use that one. You prefer numeric, go with numeric. You love the symbolic method, go with symbolic. There is no hard and fast rule that you have to use this only or this only. You have two different methods of doing the job. The same task we are achieving. But the thing is, in one case, I am using more manual effort. In second case, I am using less manual effort. Just that. Okay. So this way I can change my file permissions. So one method is, so for obtaining this set of permissions, so file permission examples, so for achieving this set of permissions, what we have to do is we have to run the command chmod okay, then we will get this set of permissions. Okay, another method that we can apply is we can use chmod 463 slash common. So to achieve above permissions, symbolic method and absolute oblique numeric method. Got it? I want to get this set of permissions. This is the symbolic way, this is the absolute way. Your choice, whichever you feel easy, you can use that one. This is clear? So how you will change the file permissions, that is okay to you. How you will change the file ownership? Chown command. How you will change the file group membership? Chgrp. We have seen an example of that earlier when we have set the file permissions for my directory there to grant access to our user. Okay? Okay, now talking about the special permissions, SUID bit, SGID bit and sticky bit. Special execution permissions. Remember one thing, these are my special execution permissions. Special execution permission for file owners. Let us do one thing.